Andrew here, Sterilizer Autoclave Solution, 704-966-1650. Option 3 for free tech support. We're going to talk about Charlie 983 error code. The first thing we're going to do is let the unit cool down, and we're going to open it up, and we're going to pull all the instruments out, all the trays out, everything's coming out, and we're going to run an empty cycle. Where the one of the first causes on this list is that the sterilizer is overloaded. So let's rule that out completely. If you fail with 983 on the second cycle after it's empty, that's where we'll have to pay attention. We'll dig in a little bit deeper. If you haven't done your maintenance in a while, verify that, or go refer to the video for your weekly and monthly maintenance. That's gonna be a filter, cleaning the reservoir, make sure nothing's in the chamber, so on and so forth. So do that if you haven't. Otherwise, it's going to be another is high limit thermostat is open. If error code does not reset, perform thermostat continuity test. Okay, so if you get this error and you unplug it and then you wait 60 seconds and then you replug it back in and you still get this error code, it's probably going to be a bad thermostat. The thermostats are underneath the chamber here. Or it's maybe even gonna be bad wiring on the thermostat. So that's a very common problem with this particular error. The next thing, okay, so if the unit skips the fill mode, make sure that the tray rack and tray plate are installed properly. So tray plate here, make sure they're pushed in. They should be pushed in about 1/8 of an inch. That will make sure that that doesn't get in the way of the door closing, causing it to leak, causing it to throw this error. Basically, it's overheating because of this error is an overheat error. So it's losing pressure somewhere, not getting water somehow. So you obviously look at that. Then you'll pull all this stuff out and you're gonna look at the filter inside of the chamber. There's a filter right inside of where the heating element is. We're gonna make sure that's clean. Refer to the weekly and monthly maintenance for that. Water level sensor is possibly malfunctioning. Dirty or foreign objects touching sensor. So the water level sensor works with the grounding circuit. Here's the wire on the PC board. It's plugged in. It's in there. It's underneath the tray plate. Specifically on the green boards, if you have a lot of rust around the PC board, you will have intermittent filling issues. And this is what happens with this one. It's skipping the fill cycle because that circuit is faking out the board and telling the unit that it's full of water when it's actually not. Then it just overheats and cooks the heating element cherry red. That's where these wires underneath kind of burn. So that's a common issue. So, okay, water level sensor, filter, we checked all that stuff. Okay, so if the unit does complete the fill mode, that would indicate that that water level sensor is in good condition. Then we're looking for pressure leaks. Basically, somewhere this thing is leaking pressure, causing it to run out of water, which causing it to overheat and trip the thermostat. So it's either gonna be the door or the dam gasket. You want to look at the door, the dam gasket, make sure that's not leaking anywhere. If you haven't replaced it, it's time to replace it. If you just put a new gasket in and you have a ring in with it, take the ring out and run the new gasket and see if it leaks that way. Your ring might have been bad. We can help you out with that. Other pressure leaks are going to be underneath the cover. But first, we'll talk about the pressure relief valve. That's this one right here. Don't pull that in the middle of a cycle, obviously, because it'll spit everywhere. But if it is faulty and going bad, you'll see it puddle up down here, underneath here. And then also, obviously, when you're running a cycle, you can look under the front of the machine. If you see dripping water or puddling down there, it could be leaking down by the heating element, the gaskets, there's a fitting under there. It also could be a defective air valve. There's an air valve in the back here. That could be bad. It could be clogged. It could be corroded. There's further steps for that. Give us a call before you want to do that. Need some specific tools. Pressure relief valve, pressure transducer, tubing connection. Okay, connection right here. Make sure this is connected, it's not dripping water, it's not leaking. It's very nice to run an actual cycle with the side panel off. That's an option too, but just before you do that, unplug the unit, take the panel off, plug it back in, then run the cycle, and then visually inspect for leaks at valves, fill vent valves here, air vent valves back there. See if you get a flashlight, take a peek in there. Could be that your heating element is going bad. We can do a resistance test. You have to unplug the power, and then we'd have to have a multimeter. We can test the heating element, test resistance, make sure that's good. If the heating element's good, then it could be a defective PC board. We can help you there. We do main PC board repair. You can send that in, and we'll get tested, fix it, get it right back to you. So, okay, that was Charlie Man 983. We covered everything. If you like this video, please share it, subscribe to our channel as well, and stay tuned for more Midmark troubleshooting videos.